Hello and welcome to another programme of Mind Your English with Shabnam Riaz.
And Fahim Bangash, of course. And like every other programme, like every diverse programme that we have a guest again today. But another aspect of the programme will be that in the previous programmes, we haven't been including the segments that you love the most. Yes.
And that's been very bad.
That's been very bad.
Yeah, bad thing that's, on our part. So we're going to make sure that we always have the segments
the
for
segments,
you.
The segments, yes. Mm. And of course, in today's program, we have our distinguished guest, Mr. Shakil Ahmed. Assalamu alaikum, and thank you for being with us.
I'm glad to be here.
Thanks for inviting me.
It's a pleasure to have you on the program. And just as a brief introduction, Shakil Saab has studied international relations at Qaid-e-Azam University and media at the London School of Economics. And the English language has been his lifelong passion. He has worked as magazine editor and chief copy editor as well. So the main reason of having Shakil Saab on this program today is the book that he has authored, which is Handbook of Functional English. And the reason why this book sort of sets it aside to everything else is because you have taken English at a very practical, hands-on level and put it into the form of a book, have you not?
Yeah, actually, I learned this language the hard way, and I'm still learning it. So I try to help those who are struggling with it, who are trying to learn it. And unfortunately, there are not very many quality books available in the market. Mm. Even in India, I've seen some books published in India, and they too does not have high quality. Mm. And people don't really work hard, and they do not have exposure to the language as it is spoken by native speakers, be it Americans or the British or the Australians. Mm. So we have developed our own brand of English or version of English. So that is slightly different than how the native speakers in all these countries speak.
Oh, absolutely. Just for the sake of argument, if we've developed our own lingo, let's so to say, isn't that okay for us? Is it?
That can actually create problems, because the benefit of English is that you communicate with other countries, other peoples. If you have your own vocabulary, if you have your own pronunciations, then this process of communication gets hurt. So, for example, if we develop all of our own, you know, vocabulary, so we may not be communicating effectively with them. So we have to be sure, at least, you know, when, for example, if a pilot is flying over France, and French have their own variety of English, and Pakistanis have their own variety of English, and say Germans have their own variety of English. So communication becomes a problem.
Right.
So in order to solve that problem, we have to be aware that what are the language, how is the language used by native speakers.
Right.
And you don't have to follow the British or the Americans. There is English, international English, you know,
yes,
which has a mix of American English, British English, and Australian English.
Right.
And some, you know, maybe from other countries.
Right.
So you have to be aware that how native speakers use the language.
Because the awareness is very important.
Absolutely.
That's
at least, you know, when you are talking to the native speakers. For example, here we use the word stage secretary. Although it sounds English, but I don't think any American or British or Australian would understand what I'm talking about.
Right.
So they would say master of ceremonies. Americans have simplified it to MC. And MC is used both as a noun and as a verb. And similarly, we use this expression wall chalking. Even a newspaper like Dawn uses wall chalking all the time. And wall chalking is not an English phrase. So they would say graffiti. Similarly, we use cash memo. They would say receipt.
Right.
So load shedding, another word that we use
exactly
all the time. So Americans may call it power outage.
Power cuts.
Or power cut or blackout even. So we use the load shedding as if it is a standard English phrase.
In fact, another thing that's very, I think, is interesting is that usually people say, you know, when they're speaking in Urdu, light aage, light chali gayi. It's not light, it's electricity.
And besides, people sometimes literally translate that, the light has gone. The light has come back.
Right, yeah. In fact, you're talking about the electricity or the power has gone and the power has come back. So that's
why we actually translate so many things, you know. Once a reporter, I think from Sawat, instead of saying lightning, In Urdu, we say Asmani Bijli. So he said sky electricity has killed.
That's another very good example.
So many animals or whatever, you know.
So now, if you know, for our viewers, for them to benefit from your book, because I'm sure there would be many, many people who would, just to show our viewers, that is the book. And this is by Shakil Saab. And this book is something that, you know, if you really want to learn, you know, English hands-on and to get a sense of what what is troubling you, this is the book you should go out and get. Shakil Saab, Functional English.
Functional English, what is that?
Functional English is the English that you need on a daily basis, you know. So I have actually given examples, you know, starting with relatively basic English to making it more difficult. So it's not flowery English, you know, or literary English, so to say. Mm. It is the English that you would need on a daily basis.
Mm. To communicate in general.
Absolutely, yeah.
Yes.
And I have made it bilingual, so it's not just...
And in fact, that would be, you know, really helpful to
That's
people.
Right.
So that also is a very important point there, that the book is bilingual. So being bilingual, you will be... You know, it would be so much more easier for you
to understand.
Many
people, they're very good at Urdu, they can speak Urdu, they can write Urdu well, but when it comes to English, they kind of get messed up. What to speak, how to translate, and I mean, which expression to use. So this book would be of great help, because you can just switch through the pages and there you go, you have your expression.
Mm.
Yeah.
So Shakil Saab, tell me, what actually inspired you? What led you to write this?
As I mentioned earlier, I learned this language the hard way, and I went through the mill, so to say. Mm. So I knew what difficulties other people would be facing.
Mm.
And again, there's no quality book available.
Mm.
And the books that are available really don't teach you the right English. Mm. They are full of mistakes.
Mm.
So I tried to make it as error-free as possible. I consulted so many native speakers whenever I was confused, whenever there was any problem. So there were so many native speakers available, and thanks to the internet, it is not that hard.
Mm.
So they're very helpful.
Right.
So
you're saying you learned English the hard way. What exactly was that?
Yeah, actually, I started my studies at a madrasa.
Mm.
So I joined a regular school rather late.
Mm-hmm.
And then I developed this passion that, this is an area in which I can excel. And it seemed very, very interesting language, useful language.
Mm.
So I know some Arabic, I know Urdu, and I'm trying to learn Pashto as well.
Yeah, that's
so
amazing.
I'm a bit of a linguist, so to say.
That's really good.
So English became a passion. Then I studied at Qaid-e Azam University, and then was lucky to go to London School of Economics. Even there, although I studied media, but English remained the focus, really.
Right.
So I would go to, for example, a shopping mall, and I would ask, what is this fruit called? For example, we use the word ladyfinger for bhindi.
Mm.
Yes.
But native speakers do not use that word.
Mm.
They would call it okra.
Mm.
So that is how you learn. That's how you learn. If you interact with the native speakers, then you correct these things.
Mm.
And I believe not very many people know that.
Yeah.
Okra.
Yeah.
Right?
That's right. True.
And you know, for him,
because
again,
ever since child, if you go to an English medium school here, every child is taught this way. Okay, Hindi is called ladies finger.
Yeah,
that's right.
Yeah. And you know, for him, that's so interesting what Shakil Saab is saying. It's the curiosity, the inquisitiveness, you know, the passion that will take you to learn something.
And many people ask you, many people ask me, okay, how can we improve? Many people ask, how can we improve our accent? Forget about the accent, all right? But how can you improve your English? You have to work hard for it. Every language has some struggle behind it. If you know a certain language, it has a struggle behind it. Be it in the environment in which you're speaking that particular language, or be it working hard, going an extra mile to learn that particular language, like Shakil Saab saying. He researched it properly, asked the native speakers, and made the book as error-free as possible.
And in fact, for him, you know, we could go as far as saying that Shakil Saab himself is a success story.
Absolutely.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
You know, you are in front of everybody.
And the book has actually got good reviews by the BBC Urdu website. Mm. And it has got good reviews in the news and Frontier. I mean, the Friday, the Daily Times and a few other newspapers, as well, Urdu newspapers as well.
Right.
So, and it has been published, let me mention, by Faroz Sons, which is one of the most prestigious publishing houses in the country.
Definitely, yeah.
They were kind enough to publish it.
That's what we're saying. You see, you see, again, the whole thing is that you can never confine yourself, because I think that is the worst thing we can do to ourselves.
Absolutely.
We are too self-critical. We confine ourselves within these boundaries that we set for ourselves. And we tell ourselves, you know, this is our comfort zone. We can leave this place. If we leave this place, then God knows what's going to happen. But no, you'll always see that it is those people who leave their comfort zones, who go out seeking something, who go out on a quest, they are the people who are going to end up somewhere and actually find something that is so beneficial.
Let me quote a very, relevant example here. Like, Shabnam is going an extra mile, learning Urdu and the idioms and the, you know, the particular words that we use.
And Fahim is my teacher right now.
Yeah, all right. I'm glad to be. So, going an extra mile, and working hard for it. So Shabnam is, and I presume that she will get there one day.
If I could add, the excuse that I went to Urdu medium school is not good enough.
Exactly, exactly.
So it is your interest.
Exactly.
So if you have passion, if you have interest, then you should not come up with these excuses that I went to a poor school, I went to a Punjabi medium school, an Urdu medium school, or a Pashto medium school. Mm. If you have the passion, you can overcome these problems.
Absolutely.
That's so true.
Very
and
true.
She goes up, you know, your story is so inspiring. And we just hope that, you know, all our viewers can, because we get lots of emails, we get lots of messages from people who are, you know, bordering on sort of desperation. You can feel it in the tone of their message, where they say that, you know, it's just so hard for us. We've come from a background where we haven't had a lot of exposure to English. So we just find it so hard to overcome those problems.
Then again, Shabnam, every language or everything that you do, be it singing even, in the beginning, it would be hard.
Exactly.
Won't you agree, Shikha?
You mustn't
Absolutely.
Give up.
And you feel free to share my contact details with those who are interested in learning this language. And I have given some tips also. There are certain websites that can be useful. And some people face the problem of listening comprehension. They can write reasonably good English, but they cannot understand then when they're watching, say, an American movie. So I have given some tips. How can you improve your listening comprehension?
Right.
And you can start with cartoons to begin with, you know.
That's very.
So if you watch cartoons for 2-3 months, so your listening comprehension will definitely improve.
Just for the sake of observance.
Absolutely,
and not for the sake of entertainment.
I mean, cartoons do not have hard language.
Yes.
They are meant for children.
Yes.
So they use relatively easy language, but it is a matter of getting your ears accustomed.
Mm.
So if you start with cartoons, that's the best way to improve
that
your
listening comprehension. That, in fact, is a very good point. So we'll carry on the conversation and we'll include our segments as well. Let's go to our first segment, which is the mispronounced word of the day. Okay, today's mispronounced word of the day, it's a word that is used extensively and it's mispronounced extensively as well. That's why we included it in the program. And the word is...
Mispronounce it first.
Okay. Yes. The mispronounced is certainty. Right?
Yes.
Certainty is what it's mispronounced as. Hmm. And the correct pronunciation would be certainty. So, you know, there's the difference of the extra syllable that people usually put in. They usually add an I before the T-Y. And that's
It's not even spelled that right. Yeah.
That way, exactly. So that probably comes from another word that they get confused in. But it's commonly mispronounced as certainty, which is incorrect. You do not need that extra syllable. The I is not there. It's certainty, three syllables, not four. So if you just remember that. And certainty, of course, means to be sure about something. That, you know, you're certain that this is going to happen, you're certain that you're going to do this or whatever, you know, certainty, not certainty.
And Shabnam, if I could interject, And sovereignty comes, sovereignty falls into the same category, would you say that?
Exactly, exactly. And yeah. They're both sort of casualties of the same sort of mindset.
Yeah. That's right.
Sovereignty and certainty, exactly, the, both are falling prey to the same.
So instead of one word, the listeners will be learning two words.
Two words. Oh, yes. That's true. Sorry. That's true. Okay. So now moving on to our next segment, which is the idiom of the day.
Well, today's idiom of the day is an interesting one. And it says, getting the wrong end of the stick. Now, that means not fully understanding a situation, not properly understanding a situation. And if you want to use it in a sentence, that would be like, her friend saw us arrive at the party together and got hold of the wrong end of the stick.
Basically meaning to interpret something else out of a situation that, you know, is not, it's just an assumption. It's generally...
Misinterpretation, basically.
Yeah, and, you know, it's usually used for something that is, you know, not positive. If you're getting the wrong end of the stick of something, you're usually taking the wrong meaning of something, which is counterproductive to actually what is going on. So you may take the wrong end of the stick in a debate, in a discussion. Something else may be, you know, be said, and you may get the wrong end of the stick and go on a whole different tangent and start your own argument. You know, I've seen this happen many, many times. So that is the
every time.
So wrong end of the stick, that would be the idiom for today. And our next segment for him
is our next segment, that would be the interesting word of the day.
Right, and today's interesting word of the day, it's a word that some people may be familiar with, may not be. The word is hullabaloo. Hullabaloo is interesting. I don't know if many people have heard it.
It is interesting.
Hullabaloo, you know, generally means a sort of an uproar, a chaos, a sort of a confusion. You may be sitting very quietly and serenely and having a very pleasant conversation. All of a sudden, the door opens, somebody comes in, makes a big noise, and you'll say, you know, what is all this hullabaloo about? So that is sort
of... Can we say that it's synonymous to all hell breaking loose?
It could be. That idiom, all hell broke loose, is synonymous to hullabaloo. Shakil Saab, what would you say, this interesting word hullabaloo? Do people usually use it a lot, or do you see it a lot?
Or very rare.
Not very, very common word, I would say.
It's sort of more and British, isn't it?
In Urdu, I think we can call it hullagulla, maybe.
That's true. Yeah, so hullabaloo, there's the interesting word of the day. So you may want to note that down, and next time you see anyone creating a fuss and an uproar, you can just say, what a hullabaloo, and then they'll be absolutely quiet because they'll be stunned, and they'll think, what on earth is this word?
That's right.
And by the time they've looked it up, the hullabaloo will be over. So let's go on to the next segment, which will be the quote of the day.
All right, so today's quote is a short poem and a very nice one, very interesting. I'm sure you like it. Well, it goes like, all that is gold does not glitter.
Not all those who wander are lost.
The old that is strong does not wither.
Deep roots are not reached by the frost.
From the ashes a fire shall be woken.
A light from the shadows shall spring.
Renewed shall be blade that was broken.
The crownless again shall be king. And that's really nice. And it's, inspiring. It's by J.R.R. Tolkien, of course, the author of The Lord of the Rings. I'm sure you've all seen
the film. It was in the movie as well.
The original was... You know, the original, it's not the film. You see, it doesn't work backwards. A lot of our youngsters think that the films come into, you know, existence. Many of these films are taken from, you know, really, really amazing books, and the books by Tolkien were The Lord of the Rings, The Hobbit, and there were a series of books, and they were, you know.
And for both of them, movies have been made. But what people do is they watch the movie first, and then they go like.
And then they decide.
Okay, we'll read the book after we've watched the movie, but they don't usually. Same goes for Harry Potter, and so people really didn't find it very interesting after they read after they watched the movie. They didn't find it very interesting to read the book. Whereas I, on the other hand, read the book first.
Well, that's the right way to go about it, you know, and I think that would be the best way to. Because it's literature, so you know, you do not want to miss out on that. And if you read the book, you will really be amazed at the, you know, the concept that you have from the author when he's speaking to you.
The imagination and the conversations that you read in the book, the expressions that you read in the book.
Definitely.
Amazing.
Anyway, so as usual, we are out of time and we are at the end of our program. We'd like to thank our guests.
Thankful to you, Shakil.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
It's been a pleasure.
It's been a pleasure having you on the program. We just wish we had more time. And so, you know, to
but
remedy
we'll definitely
that.
Have you over again because we didn't have much time to speak to
you. That would be a pleasure.
You.
And I'm willing to help anybody who needs help with his or her English skills.
Right. So on the Facebook page as well, we'll share the name of your book as well. And so anybody who wants to contact.
The name and contact details or how you can contact Shakil Saab, it would be on the Facebook page. Which reminds me of telling you about the Facebook page, okay? For contacting us, you can email us on mye@ptv.com.pk and for following us on Twitter, you can follow us on Mind Your Ing, E-N-G Ing, and join us on our Facebook page, that would be facebook.com/mindyourenglish, and it comes. A page would emerge, Mind Your English, with Shabnam Riaz and Fahim Bangush. That is the original page, yes. Join us, like it, and give us your feedback, comments, whatever you want to. And for live streaming, do log on to world.ptv.com.pk.
Especially for all those people who are saying that they're missing the program because of not having electricity at that time as well.
Electricity or a satellite for that matter. Yeah. A satellite dish or cable. So you can always, if you haven't.
So in other words, there are no excuses to miss the program.
Not to watch the program, yes. So anyway, till our next program, it was a pleasure having Shakil Saab and you people as well. Until the next time,
mind your English.